Guys, today I want to show you how to make this simple beautiful scarf. For this size is for a baby. I made it in color black. I'm going to show you how I made it, but I'm going to be using a different yarn. I use this yarn, it's Robin Luminous green, but you can use any size 4 or size 5 yarn, chunky, and you can also use a different brand like Butterfly etc. So for me, I'm going to be using this one, and I use 2.5 balls. I know it looks big, but this is 2.5, but it depends on the size of the size that you're going to make. Yeah, let's start. So for the crochet hook, you can use from size number 4 millimeters up to 6. It depends on how firm you want your scarf to be. And for this scarf, I'm making an adult size. For a baby size, you can crochet up to size 25 stitches, but for the adult, I'm doing up to 30. And then for children like below 10 years, you can do up to 20 stitches. So yeah, so let us make chains up to 30. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So make chains up to 30. 10, 11. I have my 30 chains, and then I'm going to chain one more. Let us see how long this is going to be. This is coming up to around 10 inches. Okay, and for the length of the scarf, I always make between 70 to 80. It depends on how long you want your scarf to be, an adult size. And then for the child, you can make up to 50 inches. Now, after you have made your chain up to 31, you turn your work, and then I am going to be making my first, all my stitches on this part, this back part. I prefer to leave this side so that at the end, you know, I want to put on these beautiful tassels, so at least it will have a strong hold. So yeah, let us get into that. So we are going to do single crochet on the back part of the chain, our normal single crochet up to the end, and you must count your stitches so that you have exactly 30 single crochets at the end of the row. I know I hold my crochet very funny, guys. If you have a better way, please do that, but for me, this is how I do. I hold it at the beginning. Yeah, so 30 single crochets, guys. Let us meet at the end of the row when you have your 30 single crochets. Yeah, like that. You should be holding something like this. So guys, I have my 30 single crochets. I am at the end of the row. So this is what I was telling you. I always leave this part to be like this. It gives me a better edge. And if you prefer to crochet over here on one, it's okay. It's okay. So on to our next row, and then now we start our pattern. For our pattern, we are going to, when you reach at the end, just chain 2 and then turn your work. Then we are going to be working on the back loop only. This is the front loop, and then this is the back loop. So for the whole pattern, we are going to be doing single crochets and a double crochet. Okay, so chain 2, then take one loop, insert here at the back loop, take that, and then remove 2, you're left with 2, and then remove the other 2. That's how we do our single crochet. Let me repeat that. So take that into the back loop, take another one, then take that and that. So we have our double. Again, take that one into the back loop, take another loop, remove 2,
you're left with two, then remove two, you're left with one. Yeah, that's our pattern. That's how we do our double crochet. So we are going to do double crochet the back loop only until we are at the end of our row. So for me, I used a 5mm crochet hook. You can choose to use a 4.5 if you want a very tight scarf. For me, I want it to have to be a bit loose. So yeah, let's crochet this until the end of our row. I am at the end of my second row for the double crochets. We chain one, return our work. We are going to do now single crochet at the back loop only for our next row, and this is going to be our repetitive pattern. So when you measure from one end, from this side to this side, it will come around 9 inches, but then when you stretch it, it will come to around 10 inches. Okay, so let us do this. So single crochet in the back loop only, and we are going to see now the ridges will start forming, and that's the point of doing this stitch, so that we have those beautiful ridges. I don't know why, but I actually prefer a pattern with ridges. I see it like it's more conspicuous. Yeah, and then guess what, this color is also a very conspicuous color. So yeah, story time, guys. So story time. So these cups I'm making for someone we met in a matatu. So I was just making a maroon beanie in the mat, and then he was like, hi, do you do this for fun or for business? I was like, ah, I do this for fun and for business, both of them. He was like, can you make scarves for me and my wife and my child? I was like, yeah, sure. So I was like, yeah, when, which type and blah 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 blah. And now this is the order I am making. So this small one, black one, I did for the child, and then this one is for the mom. And this color, I think actually I used to have ish about it, but then here again I am saying it's a beautiful color. So yeah, I am done with my other row for the single crochets. Now we go to the next one. So chain two, that is, now we do the double crochet. I hope I'm not too fast, guys, and I'm explaining the best I can. I'm not good at explaining, but here we are. So chain two, and then that's the first double crochet, and then another double crochet with the back loop only. And so yeah, this is the pattern that we are going to do. So sometimes you might be doing something and then somebody is watching you and they might be motivated to do it. So I think I'll try my best to be making videos for you guys, for you to try out this stuff, and you can also make yours at home, either for business or for your friends and family. You can also give someone this scarf or even the beanies, and you know, it can be a very good present, especially here in Kenya. It's a bit cold, so this one will be a very good present for anyone. So single crochet until the end of the row, and then now we do double crochet until the end of the row, and then we are going to do a single crochet on the back loop only, guys, back loop only. And then yeah, we'll do that until we have around 70 inches, and then I will meet you back when I'm halfway so that you can see how the pattern comes out. Yeah, bye guys. So I'm back with 35 inches. I am halfway there. Let's continue, guys, and this is how it is looking. I hope yours is coming out straight here, because if it is not, it just means that you are missing on the last or the first stitch over here. So this row I ended with double crochet. So I chain one, I turn my work, I continue with single crochet in the back loop only. This pattern is quite easy and I hope you guys are still counting the stitches. This should be 30 at the end of the row. If you don't have that, just know you missed a stitch. And you can also use a stitch marker for the beginning here and at the end so that you don't miss the last stitch, because if you do, it will just show you the scarf won't be a straight one at the edges. And for the scarf, I do not use like the single crochet at the end, so as in at the end here, like the way we do for sweaters and bags. So it has to be straight and presentable. So yeah, let's do this. So I'm almost done. Let me go to the next row of double crochet. And remember guys, it's here, the back loop only. I'm done. Chain two, turn your work, double crochet the whole row, the back loop only. Yeah, and I hope yours is turning out like mine with these pretty ridges. So guys, I'm going to meet you after I'm done with my 70 inches and then we are going to make the tassels at the edges. And please guys, you should finish up your last row should be a single crochet row so that it will be more firm and so that we can be able to attach the tassels at the end. So yeah, if you want to make a shorter scarf, the round scarves, you don't have to go all this way. You just need to make like for about this should be enough actually. You just need to make up to like 40 inches or 35 inches and then now you're going to join here. But for the thickness it will be something different. You can make up to 50 stitches so that it will be foldable like this, like way big, you know those cuffs for round and they're just small, you just insert them. So yeah, that one you don't need to make a longer scarf, you just need to make a short one. So yeah guys, let's meet at the end.
Guys, so I am done making my scarf and this is how it turned out. This is the right side, then this is the inner side of which you can just put it on using this side, you see guys. Yeah, there you have it. So I'm going to show you the final part, is where you put the tassels like these ones over here. I know I haven't trimmed them, so they still have one last loop to trim them. So let's get to it. So this is how you make the tassels. So I do not have like a specific measurement of how long my tassels will be, so I just take my yarn, use my hand as my measurement, I stretch out my fingers and just roll the yarn on my fingers until I feel like I have enough strands, then I cut them once, so like that. I think that's enough. Then I cut them. You have something like that. So cut them here. And you're left with that. Oops, I forgot one. Let me just remove this one. So I have that. This one's the ones that were left over. So
this is the right side of my work, and then this is the wrong side of my work. But I told you guys, you can still use it as the wrong side. So I will take, like, for me, I don't want my tassels to be like thick. I just want them to be something easy, something small, like this one. So I decided to go with just four of the strings, the ones that we have cut, like this. Make sure they have the same size. They don't exactly have to be the same size, but just like the same, like this. You can trim the edges, and then the right side should be facing you. So insert here, then take the center, pull through like that, and then wait, let us use the other side. Sorry guys, the wrong side is facing me now. Insert your hook over there, take the center of all your strings, hook it, then slide it. The reason why I've turned is because I want to show you guys. So you have that, then insert your finger and pull through, guys. So I am done making my scarf, and this is how it turned out. This is the right side, then this is the inner side, of which you can just put it on using this side. You see guys? Yeah. So there you have it. So I'm going to show you the final part. This is where you put the tassels, like these ones over here. I know I haven't trimmed them, so they still have one last loop to trim them. So let's get to it. So this is how you make the tassels. So I do not have like a specific measurement of how long my tassels will be. So I just take my yarn, use my hand as my measurement. I stretch out my fingers and just roll the yarn in my fingers until I feel like I have enough strands. Then I cut them once, so like that. I think that's enough. Then I cut them, you have something like that. So cut them here, and you're left with that. Oops, I forgot one. Let me just remove this one. So I have that. This one's the ones that are left over. So this is the right side of my work, and then this is the wrong side of my work. But I told you guys, you can still use it as the wrong side. So I will take, like, for me, I don't want my tassels to be like thick. I just want them to be something easy, something small, like this one. So I decided to go with just four of the strings, the ones that we have cut, like this. Make sure they have the same size. They don't exactly have to be the same size, but just like the same, like this. You can trim the edges, and then the right side should be facing you. So insert here, then take the center, pull through like that, and then wait, let us use the other side. Sorry guys, the wrong side is facing me now. Insert your hook over there, take the center of all your strings, hook it, then slide it. The reason why I've turned is because I want to show you guys. So you have that, and then insert your finger and pull through. So insert your finger over there and then pull through all the strings like that, and then pull them until you tighten them. So you can just be taking one by one to make it firm like that. And there you have it, your tassel. Let me show you again, guys. So I took chain. Let's do this again. So just take four of them, and you can take any number. You can actually do five or six. It just depends with how big you want your tassel to be. And something else is that you can even use a bigger hook if you're using many, like a lot of strings. Yes, so that you can, yeah. So I count two stitches, one, two, and then onto the third one. I repeat my process again. It's that easy. And then at the end, you're going to trim them to be of the same size. You see, guys? So I wanted this knot to appear on the right side. And then for the wrong side, it just be something like this. That's why I changed my mind about using that other side. So that's it, guys. That's it for my scarf. I hope you'll enjoy yours, making yours like I have done. Enjoyed making this video in my scarf. And yes, you can give me a feedback on how yours will turn out. Thank you, guys. So one, two, and the third one. And it's up. Okay. Continue, guys, until at the end of the row. And you can make the space to be wider. It doesn't have to be this tiny. Mine, I just needed them to be close to each other because they are small. They are quite small. Yeah. Again, let's do this again. So just take four of them. And you can take any number. You can actually do five or six. It just depends with how big you want your tassel to be. And something else is that can even use a bigger hook if you're using many, like a lot of strings. Yes, so that you can, yeah. So I count two stitches, one, two, and then onto the third one. I repeat my process again. It's that easy. And then at the end, you're going to trim them to be of the same size. You see, guys? So I wanted this knot to appear on the right side, and then for the wrong side, it just be something like this. That's why I changed my mind about using that other side. So that's it, guys. That's it for my scarf. I hope you'll enjoy yours, making yours like I have done. Enjoyed making this video in my scarf. And yes, you can give me a feedback on how yours will turn out. Thank you, guys. So one, two, and the third one, and it's up. Okay. Continue, guys, until at the end of the row. And you can make the space to be wider. It doesn't have to be this tiny. Mine, I just needed them to be close to each other because they are small. They are quite small. Yeah.